Hey, this is Juicy J. I would like to welcome you to the Juicy J Show. This week's guest is my man, Big G, from The Wire, the Backyard Band, and all that good stuff. G, what's been going on?
Just on the grind. Just trying to put my city above water. A lot of people in the city been doing a good job. You know, I've been trying to do it too, you know, so just basically just tie my shoes up a little tighter this year and really got a lot of things coming.
Okay. Yeah. So tell me, how did you get involved in music?
Oh man, in music, like with my go-go, I was always a fan of go-go as a kid, you know what I mean? And growing up uptown. Growing uptown Washington, D.C., you know, 14th and Irving Street used to be like the bands. Like, all the bands used to perform, like, right outside. And I just was, like, mesmerized by that and that sound. Listening to Junkyard, you know, Pumping in this Air Raid, all the older bands. And stuff like that when I was little. And my mom just playing, like, old records when she get off work. You know what I'm saying? Just the music always was influenced in my house. So I just fell in love with the sound of music, you know what I mean? Even when you sad, music just make you happy. So I was just a music junkie since a kid.
So when did you start playing with that
guy? I created the band as a kid. I made the band. I was always a fan of Junkyard. And like on 14th Street, like Park Row, all that. It was a band called Northwest Youngers. So we used to follow behind them and just watch them all the time. Mm-hmm. And I was a fan of Backyard, so we created, I mean, a fan of Junkyard, so we created Backyard. Like me and my man Anthony Borges, Hook, and Walker Lattimore.
Okay. And how did you get involved with The Wire? How did that come about?
Well, I always wanted to do like TV and stage plays and stuff like that, but it wasn't really no outlets in our city for that. So like when I was in like Harriet Tubman, like Lincoln Junior High, Cardoza, it was like little theatrical departments, but he was quote unquote gay or soft if you was in that. So I was moving my way around it the best way I can, and a lot of people didn't know I still was trying to like study my craft. But I was like caught up in the street life of that too, mm-hmm. You know what I mean? So trying to be a hard head and a bad boy, naming my name, and just doing a lot. But with that TV stuff, it was an audition came through when I was working on KYS. Mm-hmm. It was a thing called Pro Scout came through. And they was like, if you want to be the next star and you want to do this, I was like, man, I'm going to try this stuff. You know what I'm saying? I just went to the Doubletree Hotel in Rockville, me and my son, Jawan, Juwan was like maybe three, mm-hmm. And we auditioned and we made it. So we went to the next part where we had to go to Philly.
Okay.
And I went to Philly and I kept auditioning. I lose to a little white kid in the end. Then I come all the way back and do it again. And I lose to another little white kid in the end. And I'm asking the lady, like, hold up, what's next? And she was like, well, we had some print model stuff that because we like your height, if you could straighten your back up a little bit, because people think that I'm like hunchback, but I'm just double joint. I just like to sit like that because it's comfortable, but they always say sit straight up, but I think that look gay to sit straight up like that. So not saying I got nothing against gay people, nothing, but you know what I'm saying? Where I'm from, if you walking around with your back straight up like this,
there's something wrong with it.
So, you know, it's that I carried that along with it, but I tried it out. I went to Toronto and we did a campaign thing with Abercrombie against racism.
Okay.
Where we was on the billboards and we did the fist like this with the scarves in the air, with the briefs and the tees, and the fashion show part of it with the runway. I wasn't really inclined with that because they wanted to keep wiping you off and touching you, and I wasn't really with that. So I was asking them what's next. So I went to the next sector of it, and he's like, well, what do you really want to do? And I said, I really want to be on screen. This is not really my niche. I really want to be on screen. And they was like, well, you got a little bit more work to do. So I came back home, and I was at at KYS again. And I don't know if you guys remember Teen Summit on BET.
Yeah.
My man Jay Cooper, the guy that had the dreads.
Uh-huh.
Jay say, man, we seen your picture in my agency. And he was like, dog, you can audition for The Y. He was like, nigga, I'm a pretty boy. You can get it. He was like, you got the look for it, your voice, all that. Mm-hmm. So I was like, man, whatever. So he called me again. And we went and we ran the red for it. I stayed in there. And I, like, it was just like, this was my first audition. Mm-hmm. So it was a lot of people in there. So I went in and I was like, okay, they was read the paper says, get in the character, but don't go over the top with it.
Okay.
So I read for Marlo, actually, the character Marlo. Mm-hmm. I read and I was like, okay, I got to get this. So I put my hoodie on, I walked in and they was like, what's your name? And I said, Marlo. She said, what's your name? I said, my name Marlo. So she asked me again. I said, my name Marlo, what fucking part you ain't understand? So she said, okay, no, that was good. I was like, oh. She was like, no, that was good, but I wanted to know your government name. So once she said my government name, I was like, okay, I'm sorry. I didn't know because they said get in the current.
Right.
And I was like, all right, so what's next? So she was like, no, we're going to be calling you.
Okay.
So I was coming from...
You ain't saying, bitch.
I think I might have did. I don't know. But I was on a plane coming from Houston.
Mm-hmm.
And she called me and popped up Pat Moran Casting. And she was like, Anwar, you sitting down? I was like, yeah. She was like, well, you just landed Slim Charles on HBO The Wire. And I've been going to races.
Wow.
Yeah. I've been moving, man.
So, what was your most memorable moment on The Wire?
Well, I had a lot of, like a few because it was just like me just getting on TV.
Mm-hmm.
And I was so excited.
I was psyched too. I ain't gonna lie to you.
People was like, they thought, all the actors thought that I had did it before.
Yeah.
They was like, you been, what you was on? I was like, man, it's my first time.
You couldn't tell though.
They was like, nah, you been in something else. I was like, nah, never. But one of my memorable moments was when I was with Idris Elba and Will Hurst when he tried to get me to kill Clay Davis,
okay.
the councilman,
right.
Downtown.
Mm-hmm.
And we just kept laughing because every time he'd come in there because he had a nigga, he was like, you think you work for? Like that. And I was like, man, look, man, killing ain't no thing, man. But that, you know what I'm saying? This is an assassination shit. You know what I'm saying? So he... Every time then, Will Hurst came from the side and he was like this, yo, Slim will have to sit this one out, man. It just was like the magnitude of those two top actors.
Mm-hmm.
And just me in there like, okay, my time.
Feeling.
Right, that was a real good feeling for me. And we was nominated for that episode, but we didn't get it. But I thought we should have got it. But it just the work with them guys and how they embraced me. And they was like, man, just keep it. And then once they, because everybody, they ain't even know my whole story.
Yeah.
None of that until I, like, you know, caught that gunshot that time. And then they was like, man, you know, they was like, hold up. Because, like, you know, when we
this
was working.
This is the day, like, this nigga nah, wild for real.
Because we was working on set. And they was like, you know, when I first got on the show, the first, like, second scene, it was a big shootout.
Okay.
So he was like, this live ammunition, we shooting, blah, blah, blah. You ever had worked a gun before? I was like, nah, I ain't never
worked before.
But I've been around, you know, and I know what's happening, you know what I'm saying? So after all that happened, he was like, the director and the one that worked the props with the guns, he say, hey, Juan, you lying son of a bitch. I knew you know about fucking guns. You fucking lying son of a bitch. So I was like, nah, man, wasn't like that. He was like, yeah, okay. But it's just like, I had so many different moments on that show that it was crazy. Like, some of the times, like, when you just be acting, it was so real because everything was there. But I don't know if you guys remember that scene where the fat dude I was giving him going away, and I had him in the car, and he got out, and he was like, man, Snoop, why you doing this, man? And then he was like, kiss Snoop. I said, come on, Snoop. Snoop said, man, come on, man. Rat said, man, we gonna tell your peoples where you at. It was so cold outside. Like, we had the warmers in our hands and the feet. And we was outside eating the pizza, and we had the pizza right there, and the rat two rats jumped in the pizza box.
A real rat?
Two rats really just jumped in the pizza box and started eating the pizza. And everybody ran. The people on set was falling, running. I was like, just dang. And I was sitting right there watching. They was like, yeah. Hey, Anwar, we finding more and more about you. I said, man, they're my cousins, man. The rats, they're my cousins. Y'all running. They ain't going to do nothing. They just hungry. You know what I'm saying? So that was another my... like I said, I had so many, like, moments on that show. Mm. It was incredible.
I wanted to come back.
Yeah, they're going to do the movie. They're supposed to be doing the movie in 13. So they're supposed to send the scripts out around holiday time. So you got a sneak preview on that. And yes! They don't even know, but, you know, it is what it is. They get ready to put it out in a few magazines coming, so. You know what I mean? I'm just giving you that.
Juicy J getting that exclusive.
You know what I'm saying? So it's getting ready to go down. I know they, you know, they already gave everybody a heads up. They're supposedly in it. Mm-hmm. So, yeah.
Okay, now I want to talk about your big birthday bash.
The one just passed?
Yes, indeed.
Tight.
And I covered it.
Tight.
First of all, let me say, the first part of that day, you gave, see, this is what a lot of people don't know about you, that you're involved in the community.
Yeah, heavy.
You help out kids. I mean, you wouldn't, you know, some of the stories you tell, right, you wouldn't really know how big your heart is. Some people don't know that. And it's time for them to learn the real G's.
Right.
You gave a Mother's Day ceremony.
Yeah.
And I was nominated for an award, and also my oldest daughter.
Yeah,
and you had to, it broke me down, made me cry, especially when y'all brought me on stage.
Yeah, that was tight.
But when you honored your mother and got up there and said all the things you said about you and her only child left.
Yeah. All my seven is gone, seven. Yeah, I'm my only boy.
Yes. And that touched my heart. And I'm like, I never knew that you was such a loving child. like you are.
Yeah.
But then afterwards, you had the big birthday party. You was like, you coming? And I was like,
right in the same building.
Maybe. Yes. I mean, everybody was there. What? Fabulous.
Roxy.
She
partied.
I met the football player. What's his name? Lawrence Fishburne. What's his name?
There was a lot of them in there.
Oh my God, it was
a bunch. It was Sean Merriam. He was in there too.
I had Ray Grant. He was just stupid.
Yeah, he a fool.
Yeah. Something wrong with him.
His wife is my agent in L.A.
Oh really?
Yeah, that's what got me that the audition I had for CSI yesterday.
Oh, okay.
Yeah.
Okay. So.
Yeah.
Oh, yeah.
Y'all know.
Oh,
I got this from Sly Stone.